There has been a lot of buzz around Google's new OS called as Fuchsia. The natural curiosity would be to ask questions like, what is this? What is it meant for? Is it like Chrome or is it like Android? How is the development done for Fuchsia? What is the programming language that is used? Should I take it seriously because what happens to the Google's flagship mobile OS Android? Well, that is the subject of discussion in second edition of Developer Insight on CodeTutor. This is Anil Deshpande, so let's begin. Sometime in the middle of August 2016, a new repository appeared on Google's Git repositories. There was no major announcement or any fanfare, and at about the same time, another repository appeared on the GitHub for the new OS, which was being called as Fuchsia. And as you can see it, it is just a combination of two colors that they are calling it as Fuchsia. People were wondering, after Chrome and Android, what was Google trying to do with this? All I can say is that Google have a habit of becoming its own competitor. The kernel of the Fuchsia was a new kernel called as Magenta, which is actually a spin-off of another kernel called as LK, which stands for Little Kernel. If you start searching a bit more about the Magenta, it becomes clear from the documentation that it is a real-time operating system, and the documentation says that it targets modern phones and modern personal computers with fast processors, non-trivial amounts of RAM with arbitrary peripherals doing open-ended computation. The next obvious question would be, how do you develop apps for this new Fuchsia operating system? Well, there is a SDK called as Flutter. This SDK has been in existence for quite some time. This is not something new. It is a Google's cross-platform in which, using a single code base, mobile apps can be developed for both iOS and Android. Also, Flutter creates a native code. If you are wondering what is the programming language used, it is called as Dart. Dart is used for mobile application development in Flutter. However, Dart is not meant for just mobile app development. You can also build web and server-side applications. For web, there is another framework called as Dart Web Development, and for server-side development, they have another framework called as Dart VM. So it becomes quite clear that Google has chosen Flutter and Dart for Fuchsia with quite an amount of consideration. When it comes to UI, Fuchsia's UI framework is called as Armadillo, and if you are wondering how does the UI of the Armadillo looks like, here it is. The starting screen of Armadillo has got a simple user profile window, and where you can have a look at the settings, increase the volume or decrease the volume, and even change the brightness of the screen. And then there are tiled windows at the top and bottom of the user profile central screen. And each tile can be opened as a separate app. So each tile is nothing but an app. So in a nutshell, you can say that UI looks super weird, and it is also incompliant with Google's material design theme. With all this going on, there will be a natural comparison with Google's popular mobile OS, Android. So Android's kernel is Linux, but Fuchsia's is Magento. And also, Android's kernel is not a real-time operating system. The licensing of both is different. And then the very next obvious difference is the SDK and the programming language. This definitely leads to a question as to why is Google working on a completely new operating system. Well, I can think of four main reasons. Android's Linux kernel is quite old. The latest Android OS still uses the Linux kernel, which was updated on 2014. So probably Google wanted something new on which they have better control over. One of the biggest pain points of Android is the OEMs tweak the stock Android experience. Google has no control when it pushes new features to the new OS. It is always at the mercy of OEMs. Google's newest Android features don't become available to the users as soon as new OS is pushed for Android by Google. And when it comes to development, you cannot forget that Google got sued by Oracle, and probably they don't want to completely rely on Java and JDK going forward. And when it comes to licensing, I am not an expert on licenses, but it looks like even though Fuchsia is open source, it has more restrictive licenses than Android, and probably Google want to have better licensing terms on their new operating system than Android had. That's all okay, but as an Android or a mobile developer, what should I do? Should I just dump Android and start learning new operating system, SDK and the programming language? Well, there are three ways of looking at it. One is the maturity of the platform. Fuchsia is nowhere near the maturity of Android or iOS. Even Android took quite some time to become as much mature as it is now. And the second aspect is the Android and iOS have quite huge mobile ecosystem that support it. Nowadays, you don't buy just a mobile phone, you actually get hooked into the whole ecosystem of apps, app store, and all other services which become available through your mobile phone. Does Fuchsia have it? As of now, it doesn't. And when it comes to development, Dart is completely a new programming language. It has not gained much traction. It looks like it is a cross-platform application development framework, but there are many other frameworks which are cross-platforms and quite popular in the market, like Kony, Mobile First. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that there are many better programming languages that are out there in the market which have a lot of more importance or popularity in terms of learning mobile application development. So it basically boils down to how do you frame a question about getting started with this new OS. As a developer, should I be interested in learning a new programming language or new upcoming immature platform? Or you think like, wouldn't it be great to learn this as there is a great potential in this? I personally feel you should keep an eye on this and see what happens in the future. So my answer would be just wait and watch and keep an eye on this. Feel free to leave your comments on what you think on Fuchsia, and thanks for listening.